आज यू ऑल आर एक्वेंटेड विद द आयरन कार्बन डायग्राम द इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग हियर विल डिफरेंशिएट द डिफरेंट स्टील्स एंड द कास्ट आयरन शेल आई एम टेलिंग यू द डिफरेंट टेम्परेचर लिमिट्स एंड द एज वेल एज द कार्बन कंपोजिशंस डिफरेंट कार्बन कंपोजिशन इन विच इज आइडेंटिफाइड इन द आयरन कार्बन डायग्राम सो हियर दिस मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग इज यू कैन आइडेंटिफाई द स्टील एंड कास्ट आयरन इन द आयरन कार्बन डायग्राम सो इफ यू सी हियर दिस इज द लाइन सी अप टू 2.14 द एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ आर्सेनाइड स्टील अप टू 2.14 ऑफ द वेट परसेंटेज ऑफ कार्बन दैट इज वी आर सेइंग It is steel. Last class we have discussed the low carbon steel, medium carbon steel, and high carbon steel. High carbon steel means that is up to 2.14%. That is steel. Remember this. This is steel. This is not the carbon. So when we are talking about the cast iron, so it is the cast iron. From 2.14 to up 6.67 maximum coat percentage of carbon. That is your cast iron so cast iron this is see this region is the cast iron region and this region is the steel region up to 0.0022 2.14 what percentage of carbon that is called the steel and beyond 2.14 up to the 6.7 percentage of the carbon that is called the cast iron Okay, so the different steels are naming here. This is the as we know, this is the liquid region is under solidification will be converted to austenite and cementite. So this type of steel obtained here is called as the eutectic steel. The steel obtained here from this invariant reactions that is called eutectic steel. And similarly, this is the region. See this region. I'm pointing this cursor. So this is the region at which the in that position it is a eutectic reaction point as one solid is under solidification gives you two solids that is your alpha and cementite alpha ferrite and cementite. So it is a eutectic reaction. This type of steel here in that condition, the particular steel, if you see the composition line, a straight line, that steel is called as your eutectoid steel. That steel is called as the eutectoid steel. See this point. There are two points I am showing you. This composition of that particular composition at 4.3 composition, the steel is called as a eutectic steel. And at this position and the carbon composition of the 0.76 and the temperature of 727 degrees, what we got that is the eutectoid steel. So I think this is the most one of the important points of the iron carbon diagram. So this is from this we can if you divide the diagram this point also we can divide the diagram again two parts that is. If yes, okay. See this. From that particular composition, this is the particular composition of 4.3. This is the eutectic reaction point at 1127 degrees centigrade and 4.3 of carbon composition. There will be a eutectic reaction. That steel, that particular alloy here is called the eutectic steel. And if we are going to the right side of this diagram, so that is called as hyper-eutectic. Hyper eutectic. Okay, and when you go to the left side of this diagram, that is called as hypo eutectic. One is hyper. If you going to the left, that is called as hypo prior to the eutectic reaction, and hyper the after the eutectic reactions. So this is so here we can say this is hyper eutectic steel. The right side is the hyper eutectic steel, and the left side is the hypo eutectic steel. Could you get me or not? If you have any problem regarding this during the classes, you can ask me at that particular instance. There is no issue. So you have to understand what I am saying. This particular composition at temperature of 1147 degree centigrade and the composition of 4.3, that steel is called as the eutectic steel. And if you divide, if you see, if you go to the right side of this eutectic reaction, that is hyper eutectic steel, and this you go to the left side, that is called as hypo-eutectic steel, as this is the eutectic, as it is a eutectic reaction point. So eutectic reaction points. So and this left side is the combination of what is called total is what the phase we call found here, that is gamma plus Fe3C, that means austenite plus cementite. If you see here, the right side is the hyper eutectic steel, that hyper eutectic steel means the cementite, and that is called as the lediburite. Cementite and lediburite. And that the left side, the hypo eutectic, that is called as austenite, lediburite, and cementite. See this. This is hypo side. This is hypo side, and this is hypo side. In a hyper eutectic steel, you have cementite and lediburite. In a hypo eutectic steel, we have austenite, lediburite, and cementite. This is the condition. So if you see, what is that condition over here? You can see the as you see the combinations of different So what is that cementite? Cementite means, as I have already told you, it is a compound. It is a compound of iron and carbon, that is called as Fe3C. What is cementite? The question is, so cementite means that is a compound of iron and carbon. That's why it is written as Fe3C. Compound of compound of iron and carbon, that is called as cementite, and it has the maximum composition of 6.67 of carbon, and otherwise it will be varied from 6.69% also. It will be also varied to 6.69% of carbon, and it has orthorhombic crystal structure. Remember these things, and you have it is better for you to write down what I have told you. So that means here in cementite, it is an orthorhombic crystal structure. There are with 12 atoms, 12 iron atoms with 4 carbon atoms. Fe3C means now. That means the 4 carbons will be mixed with, will be making a bond with 12 iron atoms. That is means 4 carbon atoms and 12 iron atoms. So, cementite contains 6.67 to 6.69 of carbon and can combine with ferrite. It can also combine with ferrite. Ferrite is here, alpha. It can combine with ferrite to form the pyrolite. So we'll go to the pyrolite in next. So I think I'll give you the details about the cementite. What is cementite? So we got this idea. So again, if you see here, when we go to the points, some points, what is ferrite? This is alpha ferrite. Na? I'll go tell you the different points here. This is alpha ferrite. This is alpha ferrite. What is that ferrite? What is that ferrite? Ferrite is alpha iron. Ferrite is alpha iron, which is stable at room temperature. The iron available to us at the room temperature condition, that is your alpha iron. Okay. So start here. What is that ferrite? sorry for the interruption. What is that ferrite? Ferrite is alpha iron which is stable at room temperature. You have to write the all the points. If you require, you write down this, because you think, I think all things will be difficult to remember. So ferrite is a alpha iron which is stable at room temperature and capable of containing up to 0.022% of carbon at 723 or 27 degree centigrade. See, this is the ferrite which is already discussed in last class. So this is the alpha ferrite or alpha iron which is existed at the temperature of 727 degree centigrade, the maximum carbon component. See this 0.022. This is the maximum carbon component. So it is the that existed in the room temperature also. That existed in the room temperature also, and it is existed and it is stable. Stable between which temperature? Now see this alpha is started from this region. See this alpha is started from this region. This is the alpha region. This is the alpha region. Alpha is started from this region. So alpha is 912 degree centigrade. It is existed from the 912 degree centigrade to the negative of 273. Okay. From minus 273 to 912 degree centigrade, that is your alpha phase. Okay. So this is all about alpha. Then I'm telling you the cementite also. Then austenite. This region is the austenite region. This region from this position, to this position is the austenite region. This area is total area is the austenite region. So what is that austenite? Austenite has maximum carbon component of 2.14. See this. Austenite is a purest form of iron which has maximum carbon component is the 2.14% weight percentage of carbon. It has a FCC crystal structure, or it is called as the gamma iron. Okay. It is existed between which temperature? Existed between stable between 1394 to your 727 degree centigrade. Okay, or we can say it will be available in between the temperatures 912 to 1394. Austenite is stable in between 1394 degree centigrade to 912 degree centigrade. Okay, so if you see here, then austenite is over. This is the austenite, and we will go to the another region. See this region. Okay, this is the region. The I am already telling you the eutectic steel, and this is the eutector steel. The alloy at 0.76% of carbon and 727 degree centigrade is called as eutector steel. This particular alloy. This is the alloy. This alloy is called eutector. Eutectored alloy. So again, if you go to the right of this eutectored alloy, then we have found hyper eutectored steel. This is hyper eutectored steel, and when you go to the left, then we have hypo eutectored steel. Hypoeutectic steel. So in this diagram, if you see here, this phase is the below this temperature, below this line. We have above the line we have a gamma austenite structure. This is the eutectic direction. Means solid phase is under solidification. It will be converted to two solids. That solid is alpha plus cementite. This is alpha plus cementite. The phase formed here is the alpha plus cementite. That alpha plus cementite is called as pyrolite. Why it is called as pyrolite? Because if you go to the microstructure level, when you see the microstructure in microscopes, you find that this alpha and cementite will be shining like a ball. shining like fall. That's why it is known as the pure light. The pure light megastructure. I'm going to remove. This pure, and the right is the, that is called the one thing, pure light cementite. Right side is the pure light cementite and left side is the pure light ferrite. Okay, one is pure light cementite, other is pure light ferrite. And cement, you see here, the cementite pure light and transformed lignite. This region is the pure light cementite and transformed lignite. This is the thing. So then, what is the, then here the term comes, pure light. What is pure light? What is pure light? Again here, the what is pure light? What is pure light? So pure light is nothing. It is a mechanical mixture of 87% ferrite. In a mechanical mixture of 87% ferrite, 87% in pure light. This side, when we're talking about some alloys, that means it is pure light is a combination of alpha and cementite. So the question arises, what is the percentage of alpha here? The alpha here is 87% alpha ferrite in pure light, and 13% is Fe3C, 13% cementite. In pure light, 87% ferrite and 13% cementite. Then, what is the microstructure of the pure light? The pure light is a lamellar microstructure. Lamellar means, I have already told you in during the phase diagrams of eutectic and eutectoid steels, lamellar means layer by layer. One layer of alpha ferrite, another layer of cementite. One layer of alpha ferrite and another layer of cementite. This is the lamellar microstructure, lamella. Okay, see this. This is the microstructure. This is the, this line, this colorful lines are the alpha, and these white regions are your cementite. That means lamellar microstructure. It is lamellar microstructure. Okay. So what is the hypoeutectoid steel and hypereutectoid steel? That is, you call it as pure light contains 0.8% or 0.76. 0.8 or 0.76. Pure light contains 0.8% carbon is known as eutectic steel. Okay. Pure light contains 0.8% of carbon, that is called eutectic steel. Okay. This steel is more ductile than any other steels. Okay. Above 8% of carbon, when we're going to the right, that is called hyper. That means above 0.8% of carbon, that is called as hyper-eutectic steel. And below the 0.8% of carbon, that is called as hypo-eutectic steel. This is hypo and this is hypo. In hyper, we have greater than of 0.8%, sorry, greater than of 0.8% of carbon. And in hyper side, we have less than of 0.8% of carbon. This is the conditions. These are the different conditions. Different points I have already told you. This is the different points on the stress on the iron carbon diagram. We'll go by minimizing. And another important thing I want to show you here is the microstructures developed in iron carbon diagram, different phases. So if you see here different compositions, different three for eutectic microstructure. We'll see the microstructure of the eutectoid steel. Microstructure of eutectoid steel. See, we are going to study here the microstructure of eutectoid steel. See here, we have taken three alloys here. We have taken here the three alloys. One alloy line is here. This is one alloy. This is alloy one, this line. This is alloy two, and this is alloy three. Three conditions. As I have shown you in the phase diagrams of the eutectic steel, this is for the eutectoid steel. Means we have three conditions, the microstructure at eutectoid, microstructure of eutectoid eutectoid steel and the macrostructure of hyper eutectoid steel and the macrostructure at the hyper eutectoid steel. If you see the first, we go for the macrostructure of the high eutectic steel. Clear all lines. Now eutectic steel means what? This is the eutectic steel, this region. This region is the eutectic steel, this region. What is the microstructure at the eutectic steels? Just above this line, just above this isotherm line, what is the microstructure here? What is the phase here? It is a solid phase. We are concentrating on this point. If you are concentrating on this point, you see here, what is the phase? This is the only solid phase, austenite phase. So we'll see. So here are the phases. This is the phase, only solid phase, that is gamma present here, austenite steel. If you go to the below the isotherm line that we found here, this is a dual phase, alpha plus cementite, ferrite plus cementite. So how the ferrite will be formed? The ferrite will be formed that way, how the cementite and ferrite will be formed? That will be formed by the lamellar microstructure. This is the lamellar microstructure, one layer ferrite, other layer cementite. One layer ferrite, see here. Sorry, here the color lines are the cementite and the white spaces are the ferrite. The white spaces are here the ferrite and the, this coloring layer are the cementite. One layer of cementite, another layer of ferrite. This this line of cementite, see, I'm making it large. Visible? This white layer is alpha ferrite. This is the cementite. Again, alpha ferrite, cementite. This is the lamellar microstructure of eutectic steel. Eutectoid steel. We have found here the microstructure you can found easily. When you are going to the microstructure, the hyper eutectoid steel. This is hyper eutectoid steel. This is the hyper side because the carbon component, carbon content here is more than 0.8%. So this is the hyper eutectoid steel. So in hyper eutectoid steel, you find here, if you see here, the microstructure is here. The what is the microstructure? See the surrounding. So when you're going for the microstructure, then we'll going searching for the surrounding phases present. If you see here, only the austenite is there. Means surroundings, only the austenite is there, the austenite solid. So this is the only solid phase, austenite solid phase. So again, if it comes to this point, means what happens here? This phase is your austenite plus cementite. Austenite plus cementite. That means some of the cementite will be formed over the austenite. See this. This is also this height layer is austenite and cementite is formed solidified here. Solid cementite is here. This is the region. And this is the third region. See the below the isotherm line. Below this isotherm 707 degrees centigrade. What is the phase? Phase is alpha plus cementite, ferrite plus cementite. Again, the lamellar microstructure, but the lamellar, the condition of lamellar microstructure is what happens here. There is something different here. Something different means the boundary layers, as I have already told this type of microstructures during my classes. This is the layer. This is the perlite form. Perlite form means perlite has only cementite and ferrite. And that cementite, there is some pro-eutectic cementite. Pro-eutectic. The boundary layer is the pro-eutectic cementite. Pro-eutectic, where we find the pro-eutectic? Because we find the eutectic is formed here before at this point. Here the eutectic is formed. Cementite is formed. This cementite, when will be solidified completely, then it will be deposited at the boundary layers. Then it will be deposited at the boundary layers. So there is, that is called pro-eutectoid cementite. This boundary layers are called, see this boundary layers. My cursor is moving over the boundary layer. I'm moving the cursor over the boundary layer. This boundary layer is called the pro-eutectoid cementite. That is pro-eutectoid cementite. And these lines are the eutectoid cementite. This is the only eutectate cementite. This is pro-eutectate cementite. Because why it is pro? Because it is formed previously. See, previously, before the formation of the pyrolite, this will be deposited, this cementite will be deposited at the boundaries. That is called pro-eutectate cementite. This is pro-eutectate cementite. And the lamellar microstructure white layer is alpha. And this region is the colloblar region, is the eutectate cementite. So this is pyrolite form. How the pyrolite is formed? This is the condition of the pyrolite form. So again, we'll go to the right, say left side of the diagram. See this. This is the left side. This is the third alloy. Third alloy, which is the left, which has the carbon component less than 0.8%. So that is hypoeutectate steel. That is hypoeutectate. This region is the hypoeutectate steel. If you see the microstructure here, see the microstructure at this point. What is the phases present here? The phase is completely austenite. Only austenite solute. Solid austenite. See this? This is solid austenite. So again, if you go to the point, this point. What is the heart present over here? If you see, this is the phase of alpha plus austenite, alpha plus gamma. Alpha plus gamma means gamma is already formed. And how alpha is formed? Alpha is formed on the boundary layer of the gamma. See this? Gamma is already formed here. So alpha is formed again on the, this is the phase of alpha and gamma. So alpha will be alpha placed. Alpha will be placed on the boundary layer. This is alpha. This is gamma plus alpha regions. Then if you see another point just above the isotherm line of 727 degrees centigrade, just above, if you see here, you find, see, the alpha composition of alpha is going on increasing as the solidification process increases. The near the isotherm line, the percentage of alpha solidification will be more. That alpha are formed on the boundary layers. See this boundary layer. This boundary layer is the alpha and the space is gamma. I think you can visualize these differences. How the alpha is going on increasing. In the last microstructure, how the cementite is going on increasing. This is the method, how the alpha is ferrite is going on increasing. And if you go to this point, fourth point, what is the phases here? This phase is alpha plus, this here the phase is alpha plus Fe3, alpha plus Fe3, that means cementite. So it is pearlite and it will be pearlite is formed as lamellar, means one layer of alpha and other layer of cementite. So, but before this pearlite formed, we have the prior alpha is formed at the boundary line, ferrite is formed at the boundary line. That is called as pro-eutectate alpha. That is called pro-eutectate alpha. See this. This boundary layer as solidification alpha is called as solidified alpha is called as pro-eutectate alpha, and that is a lamellar layer of eutectate alpha and cementite Fe3. As see the differences, if you go to the left side, then we have pro-eutectate alpha at the boundary layer. If you go to the right side, we have pro-eutectate cementite at the boundary layer. This is the difference. This is all about your microstructures in iron carbon diagram. So if you have any doubt, you can ask here. I'm going to stop the screen sharing here. Going to the next screen. If we have. Just a minute. This is the point I have already discussed, the different points here. That is cementite, ferrite, pearlite, but the carbon component, or the stable form, all things are I have discussed. Okay. So classification means there are three types of steel, three types of ferrous alloys we found here. One is the iron. Iron is less than 0.0088% of carbon, that is alpha ferrite at room temperature. Another thing is the steel. Steel has a composition of 0.008 to 2.148% of carbon, that is alpha ferrite, cementite at room temperature, which is called the pyrolite, and the cast iron, which has So you can easily, what is the difference when we are asked to be, what is the difference between your cast iron and steel? We can easily say that the carbon component in steel is from 0.008 to 2.14, and cast iron is carbon component of 2.14 to 6.78%. And that is always the carbon cast in cast iron, that is limited to 4.5%. That means the eutectic steel. Okay. I have told you all the points related to this. Okay. All the points related to this. This is important. And this is the eutectic steel, which I have discussed now. Eutectic steel. Okay. The microstructure of eutectic steel. This is the lamellar microstructure. One is alpha, layer of alpha, ferrite alpha and austenite. This is. Okay, lamellar microstructure. This is the microstructure. Microstructure of eutectic steel. And this way here, this white layer is the cementite, and this layer is the colorful layer is the ferrite. This is the hypoeutectic steel, which is just discussed right now. The carbon component of less than 0.8%, that is hypoeutectic steel. This is the microstructures we just discussed. This is the microstructure. This is the microstructure, lamellar microstructure. This is proeutectic alpha. This boundary layer is the proeutectic alpha and the lamellar microstructure of cementite and ferrite. Individual. I am showing you in the diagram, that is individually it is drawn. Okay. This is. I think I'll take only one class, but today time is over for me, and in the next class we'll complete the iron carbon diagram details. So both the shears and bearers take the attendance of the respective sections. Okay, a total of 84 students present now. You have to take accordingly your students list. Okay, so let's thank you all. We'll meet in the next class. In next class we will cover up completely the iron carbon.